What if I told you that there are 10 reasons to buy the M2 Mac Mini, but 2 reasons to maybe avoid it? The first reason to avoid the M2 Mac Mini is that it's not upgradable. Whatever internal storage and unified memory or RAM that you select at checkout, that's what you're gonna have for the life of the device. So if your budget doesn't allow you to get the configuration that you want right now, you can't simply buy what you can afford and then add additional internal storage or unified memory when you have more money. With internal storage, there is an alternative. You can always add an external SSD, and there's some incredibly fast options on the market. But with unified memory, there really isn't a way to add any later on. Now, the first reason to buy the M2 Mac Mini is the size. If you're setting up a home office and you're tight on space, if you're a student and you don't have a lot of room, this is the smallest desktop that Apple makes. Even in this studio, I have a Mac Mini running all the audio components, and it's sitting on a shelf right in front of me. There are also vertical stands, wall mounts, under desk mounts, and even mounts that fit on the back of your monitor. Now, the next reason to buy the M2 Mac Mini is connectivity, so both wired and wireless. For wireless, we're looking at the newer Wi-Fi 6E compatibility, and for Bluetooth, it's 5.3, which supports faster speeds, longer range, and higher throughput. As far as ports, we're getting 2 Thunderbolt 4 ports and 2 USB-A ports, and this way you can connect both types of accessories without needing adapters. The Thunderbolt 4 ports are extremely capable, and they're a great option for the fast external SSDs that we talked about, and for other demanding accessories like very powerful displays. On the other hand, USB-A ports are nice to have if you use older accessories or if you're just using less demanding ones. There's also an HDMI port if that's all your monitor supports, and a 3.5mm headphone jack in case you want to use wired headphones. Now, if you need even more ports, you can upgrade to the M2 Pro and you'll have 4 Thunderbolt ports in the back, and you'll also be upgraded to HDMI 2.1. In both cases, if you want more convenient access to ports on the front and you want to add an SDXC card reader, you can pick up a hub that fits perfectly under your M2 Mac Mini. Now, one other thing that I wanted to mention is that if your work setup or your school setup supports a 10 gigabit connection, you can upgrade the Ethernet port for $100. And speaking of cost, the next reason to get an M2 Mac Mini is the price. Not only is it the cheapest way to get into the Apple ecosystem with a desktop or a laptop, but it's actually $100 less than the older M1 model. If you're a regular buyer, it starts out at $599, and if you're a student, you can get it for $499. Now, the next reason to get an M2 Mac Mini is display support. So even with this small form factor, the base model supports 2 very powerful displays, one with up to 6K 60Hz and then the other one up to 5K 60Hz. If you want more than that, the M2 Pro model supports up to 3 even more powerful displays. But what if you want a 3 display Apple setup when you're on the go or you're just working around the house and you don't have room for multiple monitors? That's where these AR glasses are a real game changer. So these are the Nreal Air from today's sponsor, and they not only create multiple virtual screens, they also make the size, distance, and position of the screens flexible and adjustable. If you've seen my main setup, you know that I'm used to multiple displays, but even with something like the 16-inch MacBook Pro, I still want more screen real estate. Now, maybe I'm doing research for a video and I want a couple of articles open, a Google Doc, and a YouTube video, or maybe I'm editing a video and I want multiple bins open at the same time and maybe a full screen preview. The Nreal Air glasses give me that type of versatility without being tied to a desktop setup. I can be on the couch, in bed, or in a coffee shop, plug them into my MacBook, and I'm good to go. They're fully compatible with the M1 and M2 chip MacBooks, and all you need to do is just download the Nebula app. So if you're ready to take your MacBook productivity and convenience to the next level, check out the link in the description for pricing and availability. And thank you to Nreal for sponsoring this portion of the video. Now, the next reason to get the M2 Mac Mini is performance. And it's not just for users who need to edit 4K video, work with high-res images, or with 3D modeling. Like, sure, the M2 is extremely powerful and it can do those things if you need them. And also, if you need even more power than that, you can almost double your multi-core and GPU performance by upgrading to the M2 Pro with a 12-core CPU and a 19-core GPU. But better performance also means that if you're not a super demanding user, you have additional headroom when it comes to performance. And because of that, editing documents or large spreadsheets is extremely fast. Creating presentations with graphics, photos, and videos, and a lot of other everyday and work-related tasks will continue to run smoothly even after several years. This means that you can wait longer before upgrading and then save money in the long run. And the next reason for getting the M2 Mac Mini is Sidecar, which is one of my absolute favorite features. If you're not familiar with Sidecar, it's a way for you to use your iPad as an additional display for your Mac or MacBook. So whether you have a single, dual, or even a triple display setup like you can with the M2 Pro, you can always add one additional display with your iPad. It's super easy to set up. You can easily drag windows from your display to the iPad. And if you want to learn more about it, I'll put a link to this video in the description. Now, another great way to combine multiple Apple products is the next reason, Universal Control, which lets you use a single mouse and keyboard to control up to three Apple devices. So for example, if you have a Mac Mini, a MacBook, and an iPad, you can have all three of them on your desk and you can use any of the keyboards, mice, or trackpads to control all three devices. You can do things like drag and drop files between devices and a lot of other super convenient things. And if you want to learn more about that, watch this. Now, if you already have other Apple products like an iPhone, an iPad, an Apple Watch, or AirPods, the next reason to get the M2 Mac Mini is the Apple ecosystem. Now, I absolutely love how seamlessly all my Apple devices work together. I can easily send photos or video from one device to another with AirDrop. I can reply to my text messages from my iPad, MacBook, or my M2 Mac Mini, and I can copy text or links from one device and then paste them on another. At first, I thought that all this talk about the Apple ecosystem was nonsense and possibly overrated, and maybe it is for some users. But once I saw how useful the integration was, coupled with the fact that there's essentially no setup required, I started missing it when I was using other devices. And don't get me wrong, you can get virtually all the same functionality on other platforms, but Apple has been doing it for longer and the integration seems a little more refined. Now, the next reason to get the M2 Mac Mini is security. Now, I don't want to get too deep into this, but you have built-in malware and virus protection. You have full control over what data apps can access. And then File Vault 2 encrypts your data in case your Mac somehow falls into the wrong hands. Now let's get to the final reason for getting the M2 Mac Mini, and then one more reason why you may want to avoid it. When I look at products, price is always important because if I can't afford it, obviously I can't get it. But value is critical. And the combination of the lower starting price with fantastic performance might make the M2 Mac Mini the best value on the market right now. Now, the one thing that you may want to keep in mind is the cost of additional unified memory and internal storage. And this could be a reason to avoid it. The base M2 Mac Mini comes with 8 gigabytes of unified memory. And if you want to go to 16 gigabytes, that's another $200. You want to go to 24 gigs, that's an extra $400. This is a lot more than what you typically pay for if you're adding RAM to a PC. Now, that's not exactly comparing apples to apples because unified memory is shared between multiple components. It's super fast and efficient, but still it's more money. Now, the other thing is that you're only starting with 256 gigabytes of internal storage, and then upgrading to 512 gigs or 1 or 2 terabytes is fairly expensive. I would recommend upgrading to 16 gigabytes of unified memory if you can, 512 gigs of internal storage if you need additional room for apps, and then supplement with much less expensive external SSDs. I mean, you can easily get a very fast 2 terabyte external SSD for under $150. Now you should see why I think one of these MacBooks is a much better value than the other. Click on my face to subscribe. You know what I always say, buy it nice or buy it twice. Good luck and see you soon.